No one had expected it, but Japanese TV was invading Australia. And it would bring more than star knives and fancy swordplay.
Somebody don't stop and they're going to kill each other.
At the Silver Ace?
Yeah, they're wrecking the place.
No.
In the world before Shintaro and the Samurai, kids' TV was okay, but it was pretty predictable. And while the kids were happy to watch, they were also up for something new.
What's the idea?
I'm breaking this up before somebody really gets hurt.
No gal's telling me what to do.
This gal is.
The sort of things we had in children's television were Mickey Mouse Club, and we had a lot of cowboys and Indians, that sort of thing. I actually preferred the Indians. I thought they were much more interesting than the cowboys.
White man steals from Navajo many, many times.
Oh, do you know what? I've discovered that one of the Cabbage Quiz contestants has never drunk Ovaltine before.
Not all the kids' shows came from overseas, but even the local shows were in a rut.
Although I have been there for a long time, I wasn't actually working for Channel 9 in the early 60s. I started in the late 60s. However, as I say, we did have a relationship. We used to be allowed to go up there to go to Desmond Tester and the Channel 9 pens being recorded in the studios at our Tarman Road, Willoughby.
Thank you, Stanley Stafford, my boy. Oh, by the way, girls and boys.
But it was that period of time where Australia was coming out of the 1950s, where everything was very, almost anal. Everything was ordered, everybody knew what they were supposed to do, even down to the family pets, I think, knew what they were supposed to do.
But the times, they were a-changing. Whether the old folks liked it or not, something was in the air.
The Beatles had happened the year before in Australia, and so people that were born sort of late 40s, early 50s, we're starting to find a little bit of voice, and there was huge change. Everything was starting to be questioned.
And it was just before it really started changing and going into the 60s, the late 60s, 70s, where you suddenly had all that culture brought out of, you know, the Vietnam War that came into Australia, the revolution in film and television and just culture that happened after that. But it was that little grey area in between real 1950s Australia and what it became afterwards.
Put them on board. You know you don't. I'll kill you now, Shintaro.
The Samurai was always going to look exotic compared to the comfortable world of Aussie suburbia.
Did you see that, Kensai?
What?
But it wasn't just the swordplay and the ninja stars that made everyone sit up and take notice.
The bath scene.
He sent his ninja against us.
The famous bath scene where we see Shintaro naked in the big Japanese bath. Back then, especially as children, you didn't see nakedness on television. It was a bit of a surprise to suddenly have a scene with Shintaro in this bath.
I was contacting various landowners about
when things got really tough, Shintaro bathed. That guy bathed through the 17th century. I'll tell you, whenever there was any pressure on Shintaro, I'd go and have a bath and think about it.
As far as I can tell, was Shusaku, who was after all a 10-year-old kid, standing up naked, butt naked, fortunately the back view, and you just didn't see nudity in those days. And we're like, did you see the bath scene? Yes! That was the big thing. Well, some of us sort of said, well, it was Pete, one of the adults, really.
Then I'll give you anything you want, if you can catch me.
The kids were sort of shocked, but at the same time, you know, really excited that a sort of adult idea of a grown man having a bath was shown on kids' TV. And, you know, we just felt the boundaries just being pushed a little bit by this program. Whereas in Japan, I'm sure it didn't even raise an eyebrow, but for us, it was quite novel.
Shintaro, Tombe isn't drowned, is he?
The Samurai also pushed the boundaries on issues like violence. But then, as the kids saw it, Japanese violence was different.
It was kind of confronting because it wasn't a comedy. So when you're watching Tom and Jerry or any kind of cartoon where there's violence, or the Three Stooges, or even Jerry Lewis, even Laurel and Hardy, there's a lot of violence in Laurel and Hardy, but it's all comedy.
We recognised that it was cartoon violence, and my parents recognised that it was cartoon violence. We knew you couldn't kill people like that. We knew people didn't die that way.
Shintaro! I really hate to kill a man with your intelligence.
The samurai's the lone gunman or swordsman, wandering the countryside, fighting off bad guys, saving the girl or saving the good people. You know, that Clint Eastwood analogy is very close.
Shintaro could be surrounded by upwards of 20 or 30 Koga ninjas. They would only ever attack from the front, one at a time. I used to say, well, just bloody get in there. If they all went in, you know, all you need to say was, now, go! I mean, he could have been mincemeat within seconds, but no, they had to approach him one at a time.